Hi, my name is Mike and I'm an application support engineer for Agilent. This short video will show a demonstration of how you can use the integration capability of our DMM and set the number of power line cycles to one or greater, which will greatly reduce the power line noise that you measure. Here's the setup for our simple demonstration. The top instrument is the 33220 function generator, and I have its output connected to the input of a 34410A DMM. So I'll be outputting a signal on the 33220 and measuring it with the DMM. Let's set up the function generator first. The first thing that I'd like to do in setting up the function generator is to make sure that the output impedance is high Z. This is important when you're sending the signal into a DMM. Okay, now we've got that set to high output impedance. We want a noise power frequency, and in the case of power line frequency in the US, that is 60 Hertz, so let's set that to 60 Hertz. Secondly, I want a amplitude to that AC signal, and for simplicity let's just set that to 1 volt peak to peak. And finally, we want to set an offset. This is actually the DC voltage that we want to measure. So let's set that to 2 volts. Okay, now we have our function generator set up. Now that we have the function generator set up, I'm going to output the signal, and we can look at the display on the DMM. Sure enough, we are measuring approximately 2 volts DC. But remember, we had an AC signal that was superimposed on top of 1 volt peak to peak. With the second display capability of the 34410A, we can take a look at that peak to peak signal, and sure enough, there it is. We have, again, a approximately 2 volt DC signal with a 1 volt peak-to-peak AC signal riding on top of it. Now I'm going to turn off the second display and show how the number of power line cycles affects the readings of our DMM. Remember, when we looked at the specifications, if number of power line cycles is 1 or greater, we have good rejection of the noise. If it's less than 1, then we do not reject the power line noise, which is the 60 Hertz 1 volt peak-to-peak signal. The right and left arrows actually change the number of power line cycles. You just see I changed it to 2. You can change it to 10. As long as we have an integer greater than 1 multiple of power line cycles, we get a stable DC measurement and we reject the AC power signal. Here we are at number 1 power line cycle. We still have a reasonably stable signal. I'll go down 1, or actually 2 steps, and here you can see a very noisy signal where we're not even sure whether we're measuring 1 or 2 volts. These levels with low power line signals below 1 provide a noisy measurement because there's no rejection of that power line noise. Let me go back up to 1 power line cycle, and again you see we have a stable measurement. So number of power line cycles has a huge impact on eliminating any power line noise in your test setup. This concludes a short video showing how NPLC can be used to reject power line noise.